who was an assistant coach back in 1966 with the Oakland Raiders when Tom Flores was the quarterback of the team. And we're underway. Seal about 4 yards in the end zone. And a good tackle inside the 20-yard line. Derek Harmon in on the play. The Los Angeles Raiders, a sputtering offense, Wayne.
They say that first down is the key for them, and I would imagine that we might see a little San Francisco offense from them. Some short passes to start out with and a lot of featuring Marcus Allen.
They have been injured a bit on the left side of the offensive line. That will not be a good omen if they do not protect this man, Jim Plunkett, who's not pretty to watch but gets the job done, the 15-year veteran. Come out of the I formation. Milt McCole is in the game at linebacker for the 49ers. In motion is Doki Williams. And on the first play of the game, Marcus Allen gets a couple, and Ricky Ellison is there, two former USC Trojans. What is San Francisco looking for defensively?
Well, I think they really feel that they've got to stop Todd Christiansen, their possession receiver for the Oakland Raiders. They're going to double him up. For the LA Raiders, we did it first. They're going to double him up with safeties and linebackers all day long.
There are a lot of people here who still consider them the Oakland Raiders. Second down and 9. The ball is on the 14. In motion is Jesse Hester, the rookie. And here is Allen. No, this is Frank Hawkins. Stopped shy of the 20-yard line. He'll be short by about 2.5 yards for the first down, and Milt McCall makes the tackle for the 49ers. The Raiders lead in the series. And more important, the fact, as Herb Cross pointed out, Tom Flores is 2-0 against Bill Walsh. 49ers bring in the nickel package now. It'll be 3rd and 3.
Put that game in the play.
Ball just short of the 20-yard line. Fred Dean and Gary Big Hands Johnson up front, four-man front. Plunkett has some time. And Jesse Hester, the rookie from Florida State, defended by Ronnie Lott. And the 49ers hold. Ronnie Lott, who played his college ball at USC and has had his problems defending against the pass in the first two games of the season.
Well, he really has. A lot of people feel that he's a strong safety playing the cornerback position, and Oakland, I know. I don't stop saying Oakland, Dick. It's Los Angeles, I know. We'll pick on it.
Here is Ray Guy in his 13th year. His average is higher now than it was at the end of last year, and Dana McLemore, who's got the speed to break it. McLemore at the 43 and gets into Raider territory. They'll mark it down at about the 48-yard line where Frank Hawkins makes the tackle. So the 49ers on offense, what does Bill Walsh have in mind?
Dick, I think he wants to take the Raider defense and keep them back on their heels a little bit. So he's going to feature his short passing game. On that magic 25 playlist of his, the bulk of them are short passes.
First and 10 for the 49ers at the Raider 48. Joe Montana, as Roger Craig and Wendell Tyler split backs. Pass on first down. And it's caught by Freddie Solomon. And will be enough for a first and 10 now at the 35-yard line, a gain of 13. First and 10 at the 13-yard line. Quickly, the Raiders' defensive line, and Howie Long is going to be a man they're going to watch all day. And a different alignment now for the 49ers, Wayne. What are they doing?
They've got an unbalanced line out there now with Bubba Parris and Keith Fonhorst, the two tackles on the same side. Wendell Tyler maybe inside.
It's Wendell Tyler inside, bounces off a couple of tacklers. Wendell Tyler running with an unbalanced offensive line is brought down by Rod Martin after picking up about 3 yards. There is Rod Martin, all-pro outside linebacker.
Way at the right of your screen will be number 77, Bubba Parris. Unbalanced line starts out to the right with Roger Craig on the lead block, and then Tyler cuts it back over here. Just something to keep the Raiders thinking defensively.
Second down and 8. Stacy Turan is the nickel back for the Raiders. Montana looking to run, will have a first down, and will run out of bounds. at the 20-yard line, a gain of 12, and that's the dimension that the Raiders are going to have to deal with all afternoon.
If the Raiders told us before this game that they were really concerned about this, especially when Montana ran to his right, they wanted to force him to run left, to come out of the pocket to his left, because he's 85% efficient coming out to his right and only about 50% efficient going to his left. But you see what happens here. He's more apt to run going to his left, more apt to throw going to his right.
He ran and got the first down on the 20 of the Raiders. Montana up the middle of Roger Craig. Touchdown, San Francisco. And for Roger Craig, that is his sixth touchdown of the season. And what a tremendous start for the third-year running back from Nebraska. 20-yard pass play.
Craig comes out of the backfield to the right. They clear with the tight end. He runs a circle pattern. Pass Matt Millen, number 55, and in for six.
Matt Cavanaugh will attempt the conversion, and Ray Wershing, who has made 115 straight conversions, currently the longest streak in the NFL, make it 116, and the reaction of Joe Montana as the 49ers get on the board. But first, we have a penalty marker down, thrown inside the 5-yard line. It is against the Raiders.
Offside, defense, 43, declined.
Penalty is declined. You heard from referee Pat Haggerty. And here's the reaction from the quarterback.
The easiest throw a quarterback can make over the middle and short, and Montana got it.
And Roger Craig on the receiving end, six touchdowns for Craig, who also has gained over 100 yards in one of the first two games, and already Tom Flores' Raiders are in a 7-0 hole early in this ball game. The Raiders were embarrassed by the Kansas City Chiefs. And in talking to Al Davis on the field before the game, he said that loss hurt a lot, didn't it?
Well, you know, it was kind of interesting what he told us. He said that if he had a choice, he would have rather had a win over the Chiefs than a win in this one today.
That's the scoring drive, and of course the 49ers started off in good field position on the 48-yard line. And Joe Montana with his fourth touchdown pass of the year. So Ray Wershing will be kicking off for the second time. Lee Montgomery and Sam Steele are back there. Seal is on the left, Montgomery on the right. There are fans, as Irv pointed out, who've come down from Northern California. They're right around the tunnel with the red and gold. Mostly it's silver and black as Wershing kicks off to Seal in the end zone again. And once again, Seal does not make it out to the 10-yard line and fine defensive play by Derek Harmon. Two good tackles by Harmon on kickoff.
Let's take a look at the San Francisco touchdown. Roger Craig, left ear screen. Now, the way you want to play this as a linebacker is keep him out of that middle. And you see Matt Millen overran it a little bit on his drop. Craig got in, and Montana had the easy throw inside.
You pointed out that perhaps the 49ers might be looking for the short passes early in the ball game, and that's what got him the 7 points. It'll be first and 10. For the Raiders on their own 8-yard line. So for the second time, they start out in poor field position. Play action over the middle. Todd Christiansen, the tight end. First down to the 25-yard line, where Mike Walter makes the tackle from his inside linebacking position.
Great call, Jim Plunkett and Todd Christiansen, a great combination. Plunkett says that Christiansen has as good a feel for the game as any receiver he's ever thrown to. He knows how to get open, when to make his cuts, and when to find the soft spots in the zone.
Christiansen coming into this weekend is the top receiver in the NFL. Remember, he caught 92 2 years ago to lead the league. First and 10 at the 25. In motion is Gokie Williams. Running to the right is Marcus Allen. Allen crosses the 30-yard line. And a gain of about 7 yards on the play. We want to welcome the viewers who saw the Indianapolis Colts finally get on the board and beat the Detroit Lions, who had won their first two games this year. So some of the surprises of early season continue. Wayne Walker and Dick Stockton here in Los Angeles, and it's 7-0 49ers.
And if I were playing defense for the 49ers right now, Dick, I'd be concerned about a deep pass.
Second and 3 on the 32. Doki Williams in motion. Instead, they hand it off inside. Marcus Allen, shy of a first down by a little more than a yard, and the tackle made by Michael Carter and Dwayne Board up front. It's been a while since the Raiders have lost to a team from the 49ers division. It'll be third down and short, a little more than a yard. Jesse Hester, the rookie from Florida State, comes out to the left. Third and short, Plunkett going deep for Hester. He's got it. Eric Wright covering on the play, and a gain of 39 yards to Jesse Hester, who caught his first NFL touchdown pass last week against Kansas City.
Great call. Boy, that's not a concerning call at all. Eric Wright on Jesse Hester, who the Raiders think of as much of Hester as the 49ers do their rookie Jerry Rice, and this tells you why. He beats one of the best cover men in the league.
Jim Plunkett with a big gainer, and the Raiders are in business. First and 10 at the 49er 27. Marcus Allen diving forward to the 25-yard line and a gain of 2. Dwayne Board making the stop. Allen, the complete player, leading the Raiders in rushing, has also caught 8 passes coming into the game.
Good play that time by the strong safety, Carlton Williamson, who saw the run, came up and forced and took down 2 blockers, turned it inside.
It'll be second down and a long 8 now for the Raiders. 9.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. The 49ers scored the first time they had the ball and lead it 7-0. Allen. He's back from the eye to the 21-yard line. And it'll be third and about 5. Milt McCall and Ricky Ellison make the stop on Marcus Allen.
That's the Raider power game right there with their big offensive linemen. They don't do a lot of fancy things. They don't sweep much. They don't pull guards a whole lot. They're big and strong up there, and they just take you on physically with straight ahead blocking, and then Allen picks his way.
It'll be third down and 4. Keep in mind that Plunkett is working with Don Mosbar, former number 1 draft pick at center. They had their problems last week. Jeff Fuller and Dana McLemore in the secondary for the 49ers. Plunkett getting enough time. Not anymore, and the flag is down, thrown upfield. Dwayne Board and Michael Carter combined on the sack, but a penalty marker is down. Here's Pat Haggerty, our referee. He'll explain.
Holding, 42 defense.
Ronnie Lott holding on the play, and that'll be an automatic first down for Los Angeles. He's number 42.
42 up on the line right there, working against Todd Christiansen. The 5-yard bump rule's in effect. Now he's got to get his hands off him.
You talked about how tough it is to defend against Todd Christiansen, how he gets off the line and gets open.
And he had a man for man there, Todd.
2 tight ends for the Raiders. Trey Duncan joins Christiansen, first and 10 on the 15 now. And Allen is thrown for a loss. Fine aggressive defense. Manu Tuiasosopo forcing in to make the play and penetrating nicely, and a loss for about a 0.5 yard for Marcus Allen.
I think the 49ers are playing so far this game without perhaps their best defensive player all around, Keenan Turner. He has bad ankles, and they were just going to find out in the pregame drills whether he could go today or not, and we haven't seen him.
Second down. Jim Smith, strong in goal line reception. Former Pittsburgh Steeler replaces Doki Williams. Frank Hawkins goes in motion. Plunkett going up the middle, incomplete, and he was looking for Jim Smith, who's got the size to muscle his way around the goal line.
Wayne, good coverage downfield that time by the 49ers. Plunkett just threw that ball away.
Third down and 10 for Jim Plunkett, who last week completed 34 passes, breaking Ken Stabler's mark set in 1979 of 31. He's been healthy this year for a change.
Yeah, he said that he wanted to be, so he worked out harder in the offseason than he ever has. Ran more, lifted weights, and He's so strong back there. He's about 225 pounds, big strong legs, and he can take a lot of hits back there without it bothering him. Third and 10 at the 15.
Doki Williams back in there for the Raiders. Plunkett's pass, caught by Smith. It looks to be short of a first down. Let's see where they mark the ball. Jim Smith, who played with the Steelers and more recently with the USFL. And it's going to be fourth down for the Raiders.
Decision time.
Fourth and two. And the ball resting on the 7-yard line, and they're going to bring in their place kicker, Chris Barr, to get on the board. Here is Chris Barr, who is 1 for 2 in field goals. He missed a 43 and he's made a 30. This will be a 25-yard attempt. Holding is Mark Wilson, the backup quarterback. And the kick is good. So the Raiders now trail by a score of 7-3. The big play was a 39-yard pass from Jim Plunkett to Jesse Hester, but the 49er defense stiffened. And with 6 minutes and 44 seconds remaining in the first quarter, here in the battle between the Niners and the Raiders, it's now 7-3.
Exactly what both teams want to do. We saw on the 49er drive, the short passing game featured. We saw Jim Plunkett take the Raiders down with medium range passing and then try to go deep one time. They did to Jesse Hester. That's just their theory, always has been.
Chris Barr will be kicking off now. The first time the Raiders have kicked off in this ball game. Most people are under the impression that if the Raiders do better offensively, then their chances are improved. But Al Davis had a different view when we talked to him before the game.
He did. He says they have to have a great game from their defense because their defense is the strongest part of their team.
Carl Monroe, who had been injured recently, is back there along with Derek Harmon. And it's Carl Monroe bringing it out for the 49ers. Monroe gets by a couple of defenders. And a good return by Carl Monroe out to about the 37-yard line. A 38-yard kickoff return by Monroe. Andy Parker knocked him out of bounds.
When you talk about the importance of special teams, just consider this. Both times that the 49ers kicked off to the Raiders, they got them inside the 20-yard line. This time on the kickoff, the 49ers special team gets them out in good field position.
Carl Monroe, who's maybe the best receiver of all the running backs for the 49ers. 6:32 to go in the first quarter. 7-3 to score. First and 10 at the 37 for San Francisco. Wendell Tyler going outside and tripped up. Stacy Terrain, in his second year from Notre Dame, made a fine play on Wendell Tyler.
The play may have looked like it was designed to go inside, but it is not. It's designed for him to bounce it out here because the tight end over on this left side is trying to get a hook block. See 71 Fonhorst, the tackle, turn it inside, and a block right here. So that's a design play to bounce out.
Tyler goes out of the game, and Derek Harmon, in his second year from Cornell, replaces him. Second down and 4 at the 43, and Harmon goes in motion. Montana, quick pass to Harmon, and he has the first down. Still going and knocked out of bounds. He made quite a move on Rod Martin on the far sideline. Reggie McKenzie and Van McElroy finally brought him down, but a good cut and a 15-yard pickup for Harmon.
Well, Derek Harmon, perhaps the best outside runner on the team. Just a second-year player on Rod Martin right there, and Martin's in trouble a step away. Harmon strong in the legs and pulled away from that tackle.
First and 10, San Francisco on the Raider 42, under 6 minutes to go in the first half. A design rollout. Montana in trouble, but he completed the pass to Roger Craig and actually picked up a couple of yards. The quick thinking instincts of quarterback Joe Montana avoiding a loss.
A great defensive rush by Howie Long that time too. It's so important to get upfield right here and then abort Montana's plans by doing this. As we mentioned, they're going to concentrate on that because they want to prevent Montana from rolling right. He's much more effective that way than he is going the other way.
Montana is 4 for 4 for 50 yards, and of course the touchdown pass to Roger Craig.
Kind of demoralizing though in a way. You know, you play the defense as good as you can and they still pick up a yard.
Second down and nine. Jerry Rice, the rookie from Mississippi Valley State, number 80 at the top of the screen. Montana to Rice. Jerry Rice at the 10-yard line. A big play for the 49ers at first and 10 at the 9-yard line. Mike Haynes makes the tackle, and there's the rookie the 49ers think so much of on a 33-yard pickup.
Both teams' number one draft choices have come through now in this ball game. Hester for the Raiders, and this is Jerry Rice. This is just a great throw by Montana. Good protection, no hands in front of his face. Working against Mike Haynes over there. Takes it inside, and Haynes come in to make the play.
When you beat a guy like Mike Haynes inside, you've done something special. First and goal at the 9 for the 49ers, and Joe Montana is still perfect on the day. Roger Craig off the left side and out of bounds at the 3-yard line. He was following the blocking of his tight end Russ Francis, and Rod Martin made the play on Roger Craig.
Francis did an excellent job at the line of scrimmage that time, and Roger Craig just a lot faster than you think he is. He's got a long stride and a high gait, and at 220 pounds, he just surprises people with his speed.
We want to welcome the viewers who saw New Orleans win their first game of the year, beating Tampa Bay 20-13. The 49ers leading 7-3 are threatening here. Second down and goal at the 3-yard line. And it's Wendell Tyler bouncing off Brad Van Pelt, the 13-year veteran who's outstanding against the run, and the former Giant and Minnesota Viking, and it'll be third and short for the 49ers.
Good control right there at the line of scrimmage by the Raiders, and really kind of a tentative run by Wendell Tyler after he got the handoff in short yards. He was looking for a hole right away, and instead of trying to pick up a sure yard or two on that and then bouncing.
Time remaining in the first quarter. Dick Stockton and Wayne Walker here at sold out Los Angeles Coliseum. Third down and 5. There was a loss on that play. Montana was going for Jerry Rice, who was claiming he was bumped by Lester Hayes. But no flag is down, and so it's fourth down, and now Bill Walsh is going to send in Ray Wershing. Hayes played Rice well.
Yeah, he'll play anybody well. He's tough. The next linebacker in college, and he gets his hands all over you right away. I know he didn't want Jerry Rice to get inside on him, but he did. And he still ended up playing the defense rather well.
I don't think Jerry Rice has played the likes of this man at Mississippi Valley State. Matt Cavanaugh will be holding for Ray Wershing. This will be a 22-yard attempt. Wershing is 0-for-1 in field goal tries coming into this game. But this one is good, and Wershing kicks his first field goal of the season. And with 4:05 remaining in the first quarter, we've gone up and down the field, some big pass plays, and plenty of scoring for one quarter. And Bill Walsh's San Francisco 49ers lead Tom Flores' L.A. Raiders 10-3. The skyline of Los Angeles. And here at the Coliseum, a capacity crowd of over 92,000. And Ray Wershing, who just kicked a 22-yard field goal, will be kicking off to Clee Montgomery and Sam Seal for the Raiders. It's 10-3 in favor of the 49ers. And this is Clee Montgomery at the goal line. And Montgomery brings it out almost to the 30-yard line, where the tackle is made by Jeff Fuller. The New York Giants beat the St. Louis Cardinals 27-17. First loss of the year for the Cardinals. Dick Stockton and Wayne Walker here in San Francisco, and this was the first touchdown of the game.
Montana to the man who is leading this team in pass receiving, Roger Craig, over the middle, victimizing the linebackers.
And the sixth touchdown of the year for Roger Craig, who's off to a sizzling start for San Francisco. First and 10 Raiders on their 29. Doki Williams to the right, Jesse Hester to the left. Plunkett and Marcus Allen goes behind him to make a fine catch and a first down near midfield. Carlton Williamson, with help from Mike Walter, make the tackle, a 17-yard gain.
That was a great adjustment by Marcus Allen on this ball thrown behind him. Remember, we talked to him the other day. We said, what do you like to do best on the football field, Marcus? He said, catch the ball out in the open. I like to run pass patterns and get the ball out in the open where I have room to run.
By the end of the year, he'll have caught more passes than any Raider running back in history. First and 10 at the L.A. 46. Plunkett getting enough time, but here is Dane Chase. And down he goes, back at the 41. And it's Dwayne Bohr, who led the 49ers with 10 sacks last year, showing his speed. Not a big man, though.
No, but he has good speed, as you saw. He'll track Plunkett down from behind. This is just a good job downfield, good coverage job by the 49ers. Nothing's there for Plunkett. Wants to go to the right, then looks middle, has nowhere to go. Watch Bohr track him down. And Plunkett's not a slow man, regardless of what people think.
Loss of 4 yards. There's Dwayne Bohr, the best all-round defensive lineman that the 49ers have. Under 3 minutes to go, 2:55 in the first quarter. Second and 14, back at the 42. Plunkett going to Hester, does not hold on to it. And he was hit hard by Eric Wright and Carlton Williamson.
Inside help by Williamson that time really turned that play around. Hester is number 84, Eric Wright number 21. He's going to get inside help from his strong safety. He's in with the hand, and then the hit right there by Williamson brought Hester off the ball.
Hester has already caught a 39-yard pass, and his touchdown reception was a milestone last week because neither Fred Biletnikoff or Cliff Branch caught a touchdown pass in their first year with the Raiders. Third down and 14. Plunkett. And it's out of bounds. Doki Williams. Ronnie Lott was defending over there, and a long throw for Jim Plunkett to the far sideline wing.
Shows you what kind of arm he's got, because he put it out on a wire over there. Both feet need to be in, and he did not drag the second one.
It is fourth down and 14, but you're right, you can see Jim Plunkett's throwing ability. Interesting that Tom Flores told us the other day, as Dana McLemore goes back, that he thought that maybe Plunkett had lost it.
Well, when he was cut by these 49ers back in 1978, they wondered if he still had an arm. They worked him out, and he did, and that's why he's here now.
Great guy to kick. Off to the left and out of bounds. And they're going to spot the ball just about at the 30-yard line. We'll take a timeout and be back at the Coliseum. 32 in the first quarter here in the Coliseum in Los Angeles. And the 49ers lead the Raiders 10-3. And I think that the Raiders always feel they're going to get kind of an irregular game from Bill Walsh.
Well, I know they do because he's hard to get a tendency on because of that list of his. You know, we said that they probably start the game with a short passing attack, and they have. And the reason for that is they really don't want Montana to get sacked early by the Raiders, because he feels that that will turn the team on.
And, of course, Walsh's problems defensively, not so much the wide receivers. But tight end Todd Christiansen. First and 10 at the 32-yard line. Montana, flag is down. Going deep. He was going for Jerry Rice. Covering was Van McElroy on the play, but it'll be a San Francisco holding call. So they started from the 33, and this will be the worst field position for the 49ers, and Pat Haggerty will explain.
Holding, number 71, offense, still first down.
Keith Fonhorst is going up against Howie Long in this game.
71 is Fonhorst. And you see his hand outside, and that'll get you in trouble. They keep those hands inside the shoulders, they won't get caught that way.
Howie Long, maybe the most complete defensive lineman in the league. So it's first down and 20. Back at the 22-yard line. Montana. Chase gets it off to Roger Craig. Open field momentarily. And Craig hit hard. Stopped at the 29-yard line. And rookie Reggie McKenzie, who was a surprise at camp, really clobbered Roger Craig, a 10th-round draft pick from Tennessee. Scores around the league. The Colts send your old club to their first loss.
New England 17, Buffalo 14, a final. Pittsburgh 20, Houston no score. New Orleans wins over Tampa Bay.
First win for Bum Phillips in the Saints. John Elway has 3 touchdown passes in that game, and Dallas beats Cleveland. One more, final score and a surprise. Big one, Philadelphia over Washington. Second down and 13, back to the 30-yard line.
And the flag thrown. Too much time, a delay of the game call against the 49ers. Though it'll be second and 18 and five more yards.
Something you don't see too often. 49ers, their history under that man, make very few mental errors in the course of a game, and that certainly is one of them.
Second down and 18. Then the rookie Jerry Rice caught a 33-yard pass out to the right. Play action. Montana being chased by Howie Long. Goes downfield, incomplete. He was going for Jerry Rice. Van McElroy, the free safety, was defending, but the pressure came from number 75, Howie Long.
Watch that surge upfield. He's so quick on those first couple steps. Working against Randy Cross, 51, gets the penetration, and then he flushes Montana right out of the pocket.
Howie Long,
his first two steps off that defensive line as quick as anyone.
He says, I was asked to move all over the defensive line before I became a prima donna.
Yeah, so I know how to play them all.
49ers go with two tight ends now on third and 18 on the 25. Earl Cooper, who's a good receiver, Russ Francis. Mike Wilson, good against the bump and one. Run, number 85, is in at wide receiver. And they go to Craig, though. Bread and butter up the middle. And Roger Craig is tackled at the 40-yard line by Mike Davis. A gain of 15, but shy of a first down. And it'll be fourth down with less than a minute to go. And the 49ers will have to punt. Max Runiger coming in to do the kicking. There's Runiger, the former Eagle. Lee Montgomery is downfield for the Raiders. Good kick by Runiger. Sends Montgomery back to the 12. And he brings it out to about the 22-yard line where Jim Leonard makes the tackle. At the Coliseum in Los Angeles, final seconds of the first quarter. The 49ers scored the first time they had the ball, taking over on their own 48 and scoring on a Joe Montana to Roger Craig 20-yard touchdown pass. Chris Barr accounted for the three Raider points, and Ray Wershing came back for a field goal for the 49ers. First and 10 at the 23. Doki Williams in motion. Plunkett. Down. Dwayne Board. He's been in there all day in this first quarter.
Great pass rush this time. Board 76. Working against Charlie Hanna, the right guard. Kind of a bull rush to start with, and Hanna lost his footing. And as I said before, Plunkett, a strong man to take down with that kind of a hit. Board got him down with one arm.
Loss of 8 yards on the play. Clock starts, and now 10 seconds remain. And the Raiders are not going to get the playoff. That is the end of the first quarter here in Los Angeles. The 49ers leading the Raiders 10-3.
This is our new baby, Christopher. And we want the best for Christopher and for all children. That's why we're United Way volunteers. We visit the schools, we talk with the children.
Hi, kids.
Hi.
We're here today to talk to you about the Sunrise program. There are 3,300,000 problem drinkers in the age group from 14 to 17.
That's why we're here. These children themselves are evidence that we aren't too early in starting this education to help them make important choices they'll have to face.
If we've gotten even one child not to use alcohol, then we've succeeded. More and more of us in the National Football League are joining in this fight, and it's a fight we can't afford to lose. And when you choose to help through your support of the United Way, we can all be winners. So these kids will have a better tomorrow.
This message furnished.
We start the second quarter here in Los Angeles. Dick Stockton and Wayne Walker and Jim Plunkett leading the Raiders, who are trailing 10-3. It'll be second down and 18, just about at the 15-yard line for the Raiders. Plunkett has time, goes up the middle. to his tight end Todd Christiansen, who makes the catch. Gain of 7 on the play. Former number one draft pick Don Mosebar has moved in at center. Maybe a changing of the guard for the Raiders there, Wayne.
There has only been two centers in the history of this franchise, Jim Otto and Dave Dalby, who Mosebar is starting in place of today. There's Dalby on the sidelines. He's played in 192 straight games. Never missed one for the Raiders, but I think now it's just going to be Mosebar's turn.
Dalby is listed with having turf toe, but it could be kind of a convenient way of moving Mosebar in there. In any event, Mosebar is the center. It's second down and 11. Back at the 22-yard line. Make it third and 11. Plunkett's pass. And Jesse Hester is there to make the reception and a first down at the 46. Eric Wright covering all the way. Well, we've seen Jerry Rice, the rookie for the 49ers, and now Hester with a second big catch.
Again, the 49ers back here in single coverage. And watch Hester work from the inside, then run a corner pattern. And Wright was just off him. Plunkett takes a shot afterwards. Jeff Fuller, number 49, on a blitz.
And he knows how to give a shot. Hester has caught two now for 64 yards. Marcus Allen goes in motion, and Frank Hawkins carries. Jim Stuckey, who came in for Jeff Stover momentarily at left defensive end, makes the stop at midfield. It is very hot over on the 49er bench, and for that matter on the field. We were walking before the game, and I got to think it's got to get to the century mark.
I suppose it's just as hot around the Raider bench, too, because you're going to see a lot of substitutions, I would think in particular in the defensive line because for the big people, because it's going to be up in the 90s.
You don't think they have air conditioning over on the Raider side, do you? Second and 6, midfield. Allen. Brought down at the 45 of San Francisco. Stuckey and Lott make the tackle, and they're about a yard and a half away from a first down.
Talk so much about Todd Christiansen, his pass-catching ability. Watch him block here. Taking on Milt McCall, number 53. Stays with him, ties him up, and Marcus Allen is by for some yards.
Third and 2. Frank Hawkins. Piled up, and it may be close. Hawkins, the short yardage running back and the blocker, is close to a first down at about the 43-yard line. Ricky Ellison and Ronnie Lott. Again, two players who played on this very field, playing for USC in their college days. And we are going to have, I believe, a measurement to see whether Hawkins got the first down.
Excellent job on that last play defensively by the nose tackle Michael Carter, who has come into the game in place of Tuiasa Sopo.
It is a Raider first down. The Raiders had 10 days to get ready for this game after their loss to Kansas City, and the 49ers, of course, as we look at a rousing game in which San Diego beat Cincinnati 44-41, and the Giants beat St. Louis 27-17 in an NFC East battle. The 49ers coming into this game really played only two solid quarters out of their first eight.
And it's almost time here, you get the feeling, Dick, for the Raiders to go deep again.
They're at the 49er, 43. Trey Junkin, a tight end in motion. Plunkett goes to Marcus Allen inside. And he goes to Allen underneath, who gets it out to the 39-yard line and a pickup of about 5 yards. Ronnie Lott and Ricky Ellison again make the stop on Marcus Allen.
That's the play action fake here now. Allen is number 32. He's the tailback. He'll delay, no blitz coming, and then sneak out, looking downfield, nothing there, and then just dumps off right here. Nice, easy, sure pass.
They worry about the tight end, Todd Christiansen.
They wanted to get him out in that pattern. That's who Plunkett was looking for at first.
Junkin, the tight end, the second tight end moving, and here's Allen with a head of steam. Penalty marker is down as Marcus Allen fights his way to the 35-yard line, about a yard short of a first down. Wayne Board and Manu Tuiasa Sopo make the stop, but this penalty's against the silver and black. Two games in progress right now that we'll bring you up to date on in the National Football League. The Jets over Green Bay.
Holding, number 79, offense, still second down.
Bruce Davis, the left tackle, and no score between Kansas City and Miami. Davis is in for Shelby Jordan, who has a groin pull. Of course, Charlie Hanna is in for Kurt Marsh, who had a broken arm, is on injured reserve. So it's that left side that's a little shaky for the Raiders on that offensive line. Second down and 16, back at the 49. Allen. And Ricky Ellison following Marcus Allen all the way, but Allen picks up 10 yards, and it'll be third down and about six following the penalty. Having a good year.
Norv Hecker, the linebacker coach, said this will be Ricky Ellison's kind of game. He likes to play against a power runner like Marcus Allen and against a power team, and he's been in a lot of plays so far this afternoon.
Protege of Hacksaw Reynolds, who called him Fruit Loops. Not that Hacksaw was playing with a full deck in his own right. Third and six at the 39. Plunkett intercepted. Todd Shell. Not pretty, but he'll take it, and that's the first 49er interception of the year. And Shell brings it back to the Raider 40-yard line.
Not a lot of pressure early, but watch from the left. Fred Dean comes in late, but that was just a bad throw by Plunkett, who didn't look like he saw the linebacker out there. Todd Shell, their number one draft choice of a year ago, a great athlete. This kid high jumped 6'10 when he was in high school, and he's a big play person. Bill Walsh says he's not a great player now. He's a great athlete, has the potential to be a great player.
He took over for the veteran Dan Buns. A 33-yard return. First and 10 at the Raider 40. Jerry Rice in motion. Montana going up the middle to Wes Francis, who makes a fine high catch and is brought down at the 20-yard line by Van McElroy, and a first down for the 49.
But watch Montana's footwork. He gets pressure from outside right there, steps up, maintains his poise, continues to look downfield, and that was a great catch by Russ Francis.
A 20-yard gain by Francis, who is an integral part of the 49ers blocking up front. First and 10, San Francisco on the Raider 20. Francis goes in motion. Wendell Tyler going outside to the 15, and he's upended right up near the 10-yard line and close to another first down. And Mike Davis, the strong safety, makes the play on Tyler, who played his college ball here at UCLA.
Gosh, I doubt if the Raiders have ever seen that kind of play before. I don't know whether I have. They put Russ Francis, the tight end, in motion across the formation, and he ended up blocking the cornerback, Mr. Hayes, who was playing bump and run on the wide receiver.
9-yard gain.
10 minutes to go in the first half. The 49ers lead 10-3. And marching for more. The 49ers' record is perfect. Montana has the first down. Quarterback sneak inside the 10-yard line.
We asked Montana yesterday, Dick, if this was a special game for him. Was it more than just 1-16 because it was against the Raiders? And he said, well, he said, I live down here now. He says, so it's really important for me to beat these guys. A couple of them live close to me.
Some of the defensive backs who play for the Raiders come by. He says, I don't mind the fans screaming Raiders when they come by the house, but it's the defensive backs. So he wants to win because, in a way, this is his territory, too. First and goal in the eighth for the Niners. Montana is 8 of 10. Tyler in motion. Swings it out. He was going for Francis. And covering on the play was Jeff Barnes, the outside linebacker.
So Barnes, one of the best nickel linebackers in the league. They, of course, play Van Pelt on the running situations, bring him in, number 56, in the pass situations, and he's good as anyone.
Ninth year for Jeff Barnes, and he has the kind of rare speed that linebackers have to stay with the receiver. Joe Montana, off to a good start. He didn't play in the last two preseason games, had a back injury, was a little bit rusty. Two tight ends now. But Roger Craig isn't going anywhere and will lose a couple on the play. Compliments of Rod Martin.
It's wasn't a clean-looking play right here for the 49ers, but you can credit the Raider defense. Martin, number 53, jumped inside of Russ Francis at the snap and just beat him cleanly.
The 49ers, who want to make sure they get something out of this drive, have called the first of their three timeouts in the half with 8:43 remaining, and so we'll return to the Coliseum in a moment. The 11-yard line. Derek Harmon in the backfield goes in motion. And Montana looking, firing, incomplete. Jerry Rice defended by Van McElroy. Dancing back there was Joe Montana, and he went for the rookie.
Tremendous vision Montana's got. Even when moving around back there, he can see the whole field, and I'm sure that Jerry Rice is going to look back and see this is a ball right here that I should have caught in his hands.
But he dropped it. It's fourth down, and Ray Worthing, who has already kicked a 22-yard field goal, will try a 28-yarder now with Matt Kavanaugh holding. Loose ball. And it'll be down right there at the 19. Raiders block it and get it back. Greg Townsend, defensive lineman, might have gotten his hand on it. And there's a flag down.
Let's see if the kick was low. It doesn't look like it was all that low, but it was just tremendous penetration by Townsend. He was 5 yards deep when Worsing put his toe to the ball.
And a big conference out there.
Personal foul, number 99.
Get that penetration by Townsend coming through the gap over here on the left side. And Sam Seal, 43, back there too with some pressure. But it was Townsend who got the hand on it.
Sean Jones of the Raiders, though, has been called for the personal foul. And the officials are going to go as far away as they can, at least from the 49ers. They're closer to the Raiders to decide this one. They have announced to Pat Haggerty that Sean Jones out of Northeastern was guilty on the personal foul. So it'll be Raider ball, but it'll be set back just inside the 10. The Raiders have not had the benefit of good field position throughout most of this first half, while the Niners have. Here's Haggerty again.
Personal foul, number 99, first down.
Tom Flores might have been more graphic in his reaction to the block by his team, the Raiders.
He was hoping for a big play, that it would bounce up into somebody's hands and they'd be off for 6 points. Happens a lot in those situations.
And those are the kind of plays that turn games like this around.
I think that's part of the reason that Al Davis was telling us you have to have those kinds of plays from your defensive team here in Los Angeles, because that's our strength, and they have to make those kinds of plays for us to win.
First and 10 Raiders on the 10-yard line. They send Marcus Allen to the top. And Frank Hawkins is thrown for a loss by Dwayne Board.
What a game.
He has two sacks and penetrated beautifully there to knock Frank Hawkins down for a loss. And so Dwayne Board, who takes the film home and studies his opponent, did his homework this week.
He's got that serious look on his face over here. Board will be lining up to the right-hand side. Let's see if we can pick him out right in here. Come across, get penetration, and make the play. Look at that. They took on two guys and split them both.
Second down and 13, back at the 7-yard line. Marcus Allen trying to find some open room, dives to the 10-yard line, just about back to the original line of scrimmage. And it'll be third and 10.
He almost had a chance to cut back and pick up some big yardage on that play, but guess who was standing there to prevent him from the major cutback? Was Dwayne Board, number 76.
He had help from Todd Shell. And now we have an official timeout. The Raiders have started all five of their possessions inside their own 30-yard line. Right now, they're on their 10, and we'll be back to the Coliseum. These teams have won all but one of the Super Bowls in the 80s. Shelby Jordan comes in the game at left tackle. Bruce Davis moves to left guard as Charlie Hanna comes out with injury. Third down and 10. Plunkett back at the 1 yard line. Completes the pass at the 22. Jokey Williams. But Dana McLemore, the nickelback, was there. A gain of 12 yards on the play, and it will be a first down. Raiders.
Jokey Williams, number 85. McLemore, 43. McLemore giving him some room, and Williams just done a little turn on him. McLemore playing with a pretty big cushion.
Big play for Doki Williams and Jim Plunkett on third down. Williams, they say, will be a star. He only needs some work. He was at UCLA and was a world-class triple jumper. He was at the Olympic trials in 1980. Comes out to the right, first and 10 at the 23. Plunkett loops it over to Hawkins. Frank Hawkins past the 30-yard line and close to a first down and may have it. Ricky Ellison on the tackle, but it's another Raider first down.
You noticed how much that the Raiders have gone to the short passing game. Just a real short drop by Jim Plunkett here. In the old days, they used to go back seven-step drop and hold the ball, let the receivers work downfield deep, and now they've changed their theory some here recently.
Plunkett goes back to the five-step drop, but he's hit a couple of long ones, but that hasn't been the bread and butter so far in this one. 6:40 remaining in the first half. First and 10 Raiders on their own 35. Marcus Allen runs into Ronnie Lott, runs into his own man, and is stopped back at the line of scrimmage by Jeff Stover. Ronnie Lott had penetrated so well that he managed to get Marcus Allen before he got underway.
Lots will be lined up on the outside here. Now watch his penetration on. I don't think he blitzed. I think he just read run and came in, and watch him take on Frank Hawkins and deliver a typical Ronnie Lott type of hit. Right there, spin back in, hit Allen, and that's a great defensive play.
He was like a pinball.
Yes, he was.
Marcus Allen on that play. Second down and 10. Plunkett caught by Doki Williams on a comeback pattern and brings it out to midfield, where the Raiders have their third first down of this drive. Ricky Ellison and Mike Waller make the tackle. Good for 14 yards. A good comeback pattern by Doki.
You really got to credit the offensive line. Now they're doing a good job. Now watch Plunkett. He doesn't even have hands up in front of him or anything like that. He has a complete clear alley to throw through. They're picking up really well at the line of scrimmage, and the 49ers on defense aren't getting much push.
Joe Montana is having a fine game percentage-wise, and so is Jim Plunkett. 10 of 15 for 155 yards. Plunkett will go to the air again. Christiansen at the 49er, 44-yard line, where Mike Walter and Carlton Williamson make the tackle. Pretty tough play to stop there.
Watch Christiansen get a release here now inside of Milt McCall. He fights his way through. He sees them sitting in the zone right there, so he just runs a curl pattern in front of the zone.
Third catch of the game for Christiansen, who came in leading the NFL with 17. Second and 4 at the San Francisco 44. Plunkett to Marcus Allen. He may have a first down. Let's see where they spot it. He might be short by a little bit at about the 49 or 40. Ricky Ellison tried to prevent the first down. It may be close enough for a measurement.
Pretty interesting, isn't it? The short passing game of the Raiders. You know, you said at the top of the telecast, Dick, that Bill Walsh was an assistant coach with the Raiders and Tom Flores was the quarterback. I think Flores has shown his old coach that I know some of that short passing game myself.
They have it. Here's what Tom Flores said about Bill Walsh. He was very young when he came to the ball club, and he said, "I'm new to the pros." He didn't act like he knew it all.
He said, I'm going to learn right along with you guys. And learn he did,
I guess. 4:05 remaining in the first half. The Raiders have been moving the ball. They were inside their own 10, actually at the 7, and now they have it first and 10 on the San Francisco 40. Trailing the 49ers 10-3. Plunkett swings it out to Hawkins. And Hawkins picks up 8 yards. Mike Walder makes the tackle. So it's the short passing game again. That's nibbling away at the 49er defense, and it'll be second and short. The quarterback dream right now for Plunkett.
They ran both backs out of the backfield. I'm kind of flooded it over there on the 49ers defensive left, and Mike Walter had to take the second back from his inside linebacker position and was late getting there.
Second down. At the 32-yard line. Plunkett calls an audible at the line of scrimmage. Quick pass. And a first down for the Raiders. Inside the 30-yard line to Doki Williams with Eric Wright covering him all the way.
What his teammates say about him, you know, he's not beautiful. He's not 6'4" and blonde, but he can get the job done. Playing pretty loose out there on the corner position. Eric Wright about 7 or 8 yards off at the snap.
Plunkett is mixing it up, and Howie Long waiting to come back in the game. Doki Williams has caught 3. Todd Christiansen has caught 3, and Plunkett has completed 10 of his last 11 passes. First and 10 on the Niner, 26. Hawkins trying to go wide. No, Kenny King is in the game. And Milt McCall makes the tackle. Maybe a yard and that's all. So Kenny King, who lost his fullback position to Frank Hawkins, is stopped by that man.
Sensational play too. He took the tight end Todd Christiansen and just strung that thing out until Hawkins ran out of room.
Kenny King had been a fixture in the backfield for the Raiders. Now will back up Marcus Allen. They feel he is better off as a halfback with Frank Hawkins the blocking fullback. And as we've seen today on the receiving end. That's the time remaining in the first half. 10-3 San Francisco. Second and 9 at the 25. Plunkett looking for a receiver and overthrows his man. Jesse Hester, the intended receiver. And good coverage downfield by the 49ers secondary. And Hester may be shaken up.
Excellent composure that time by Plunkett also, who moved around and bought some extra time in the pocket.
Cliff Branch, who of course has been a landmark for the Raiders, on injured reserve, and so Jim Plunkett has had to go with Hester, the number one draft pick, and Doki Williams, a youngster.
Well, Al Davis said that Cliff Branch on injured reserve was truly a great player. It's a real loss. He said he mentioned him number one, not having him and Ted Hendricks, he mentioned about this team. He said those two guys, the loss of them really hurt us. Branch is a tremendous player that the opposing team had to deal with every Sunday.
And that's what they think the likes of Jesse Hester and Doki Williams will become. But of course that doesn't happen overnight. And Hester getting off on his own power.
Watch out there now. 21 is right. Plunkett's moving around. Now he throws, and Wright will close on the ball as it's in the air. Get there just as it arrives. And then Hester was banged up a little bit in that pileup.
Tough play for a receiver with a defender on his back to go up. It'll be third down and about 9. That's what Hester has done so far this year, and of course he caught a touchdown pass against Kansas City.
49ers haven't been able to get a whole lot of pressure on Jim Plunkett today with their down linemen, and when they bring in their four down linemen on the nickel situation, they really haven't gotten much pressure on him. And you almost get the feeling that to do so, they're going to have to take some chances and perhaps blitz.
Plunkett has thrown one interception, the only turnover in the ball game, that by Todd Shell. 49ers could not take advantage of it as Ray Wershing's kick was blocked. Let's bring up to date on a couple of baseball scores affecting it with a red hot second quarter. 10 of 12. Third and 9 at the San Francisco 25. This is the 13th play of the series coming up. Plunkett going up on top. And it's dropped there by Jim Smith. Covering was Eric Wright on the play. Wayne, did you think Smith should have held on? Wright was right with him.
Let's take a look. 21 is Eric Wright. Looks like they got their feet tangled up a little bit. Eric Wright went down and reached out, and he had a hand on Smith's leg as the ball was coming.
Now, the 49ers had a blitz on that time, but the Raiders picked it up extremely well.
And a little body English from Mr. Plunkett. So it's fourth down, and Chris Barr, who connected on a 25-yard field goal attempt, will try one from 42 now with Mark Wilson holding. 2:08 remaining in the half. And this kick is good, no good. Off to the left. Chris Barr missing a 42-yard field goal. And the 49ers will take over.
Good view at it right here. Good set, plenty of time, not much pressure, and it'll just fade left. That's the side that the soccer-style kicker will pull the ball. It's called pulling it, like in a golf swing, and they just pulled it wide left.
So both field goal kickers have missed one here in the second quarter. Ray Wershing had one blocked. Tom Flores was hoping he could get three more points on the board, but it wasn't to be. And with 2:03 to go, the 49ers have it first and 10 on the 25. Inside to Wendell Tyler. Close to a first down at the 35-yard line in terrific acceleration. And now we're going to have our two-minute warning here at the Coliseum with the Niners leading 10-3.
By saying perhaps that's just coaching anxieties, that sometimes when you're playing a good team like this that you're afraid you can't score, and then you hope that they can't either.
Kind of candid. Don't forget, next week, college football on Saturday on CBS. Texas against Stanford. The Longhorns won yesterday.
They did. Stanford, of course, with another in a long line of great quarterbacks. John Pay there now.
Some of you will see a Pac-10 battle between UCLA. They also were victorious against the Washington Huskies. Both teams expected to make strong bids for the Rose Bowl. So college football next Saturday, 3:30 Eastern, 12:30 Pacific, here on CBS Sports. Joe Montana, who has thrown a touchdown pass, the only score of the game to Roger Craig. The first time the 49ers had the ball. It was 10-3 after one quarter and has settled down into kind of a defensive battle, with each side missing a field goal in this second quarter. 1:58 to go. Swing pass out to Craig. Craig with the first down, pulls his way into Raider territory. This man can do no wrong in the 1985 season so far, and that was a 17-yard pickup.
And that's all you hope for in that situation when you're the 49ers, is get it out to him and hope he breaks the tackle. He did.
Matt Millen and Van McElroy to stop. Lining up without a huddle. First and 10 at the 48. Montana up the middle off of Craig's hand. Defended up the middle by Matt Millen. Stops the clock with 1:30 remaining, and it'll be second down and 10. 49ers have two timeouts remaining. They used one earlier. The Raiders have all three of theirs.
Montana said for him, the Raiders are a tough team to play, Dick, because they get a better push off the line of scrimmage, and there's people back in his pocket with hands up and stuff more than anyone they play.
At the 48, second and 10. Pressure, blitz. Townsend came in, and Montana had to get rid of it in a hurry. He was going for Wendell Tyler, but it was Greg Townsend who puts pressure as the fourth defensive lineman and can really blow off that line that almost nailed Joe Montana for the first time today.
The push that we're talking about, you just saw, but then Montana combats it with his quickness and alertness. And then how do you combat that? You got to play with an extra guy sometimes against Montana, it seems like. It's very demoralizing to a defense to get that kind of play and get the blitz and get in there, and it really didn't mean much.
Timeout call.
San Francisco, number 2.
Don, Joe Montana, Greg Townsend lined up here at defensive end. You would think Wendell Tyler right here would block him, step up and block him, but as Townsend came in, Tyler ran by him, perhaps a missed assignment. Now, if Montana would have been able to look over here right away, and right now he could have dumped it, but Townsend was back there in his face too quickly.
Third and 10, four wide receivers for the 49ers, including Mike Wilson, good against the bump and run. Montana's pass to the sideline to Jerry Rice is caught, and a first down. Flag is also down inside the 40-yard line. And several of the Raiders and 49ers converge over the official who threw the flag. It was good for 10 yards. At the 38-yard line, let's see if they have the first down and who the penalty is against. Pat Haggerty.
A hit late. Alzado was back there on Montana just as he threw. Perhaps that was it.
Offensive pass interference number 85. Defensive roughing the passer number 77. Offset the penalty, played again.
You're right about Alzado, and we're talking about Mike Wilson on the bump and run, but here is Alzado.
Here's the end of it right here. That's that area where they want him to let up. I mean, Alzado didn't give him a full massage, but he didn't let up much on him either.
So they'll play it again in 1:21 showing on the clock. It'll be third down and 10. Keep in mind that before we went to the last commercial, the 49ers called a timeout. Here's Wilson working against Stacy Turan. He should be in the ring. 49ers have one timeout remaining with 1:21 showing on the clock in the half. Carl Monroe, good receiver, number 32 in the backfield along with Roger Craig. Montana going up on top. Jerry Rice. And they say it is caught, and a first down at the 10-yard line. Lester Hayes and Van McElroy, and a 38-yard pass. Montana gets a big chunk of yardage to the rookie, Jerry Rice.
Let's see, starts in. See how Hayes plays him if he gets a bump up here. He doesn't get a bump on him, so it's a foot race now. And did you see Jerry Rice put it in another gear when the ball was in the air? And look out for the camera, guys.
Ooh. We hope he's all right. It was Lester Hayes, the man beaten. Yep, he's fine. Beaten by Jerry Rice. First and goal at the 10. Montana down. Back at the 19-yard line by Jeff Barnes. Coming in from the outside linebacking position. Barnes just stormed in on Joe Montana. Loss of 8. 1:06 and the clock is running. Second down and 18. Montana forced to run, chased by Long, and Joe Montana will stop the clock as he goes out of bounds at the 13-yard line with 54 seconds to go in the half.
We told you that Montana said the Raiders and their push up front are the best in the league. Howie Long, 75 against Bonhorst, and here comes the push he's talking about, depth in the pocket. That got Montana out of there. Long, although he doesn't get every sack back there, sure creates a lot of opportunities for his teammates along the defensive line, because he gets that push almost every play and chases the quarterback into a lot of sacks.
The 49ers cannot get a first down. It is third down and goal, in essence, on the 14-yard line with 54 seconds to go and one timeout left. They are in position, of course, if they do not score here, to try a field goal. Dwight Clark to the bottom of his screen as Montana calls the audible. Craig inside the 10, and it looks like the 49ers are just trying to set up a field goal possibility here in the waning seconds of this first half. Tackled by Dave Stalls for the Raiders.
Five-yard gain.
It's fourth down, and the 49ers want to make sure that they run off enough time so that the Raiders don't get another chance to do something when they have the ball. They have one timeout remaining. Of course, you can't let too much time run down, Wayne.
You don't want it to get less than 5 seconds, because if you get a penalty, you want to have time to kick it again.
And that's just what they wanted. Timeout. 5 seconds it is. The 49ers have used up their last timeout with 5 seconds to go in the half to set up Ray Wershing's field goal attempt. He has made a 22-yard field goal to give the Niners their 10-3 lead, and later on had a 28-yarder blocked. This will be a 27-yard attempt. Matt Kavanaugh holding.
Okay, Wershing shot the field goal. Matt Kavanaugh to hold.
And the flag is down. The kick is good, but a penalty marker is down. So hold it. It's against the Raiders. The 49ers will decline. And it's 13-3 in favor of the San Francisco 49ers with Ray Wershing with his second field of the game.
Offside, defense, decline, score. score counts.
1 second remaining. 27-yard field goal to make it 13-3. And this is really kind of a ball control, field position, strategy, chess kind of game we're seeing today.
Two teams, I think, you know, like, they're very wary of each other, very respectful of each other. And they're sticking to what they think they can do. Bill Walsh said that he really didn't feel that they could run against the Raiders in the first half. He thought, if we get a halftime lead, we may be able to run in the second half because they may be somewhat tired. But he said, a fresh Raider defense, we're not going to be able to run against them.
Is this kind of a lead for the 49ers sufficient in them for them to run the ball? Or 10 points is not that much, is it?
Bill Walsh told me last week that he thought it's the most precarious kind of lead. It's like the lead Atlanta had on the 49ers. Go ahead, 10 points and two plays and it's gone.
49ers, who are trailing 10-0 at the halftime, came back with 35 second half points. Coming up at halftime, scores and highlights from our studios in New York. Brent, along with Dick Vermeil, a second to go.
The Raiders think that the Worsham will probably squib it, I'm sure. But I think you're better off in this situation. I just kick it on down. We'll see. Worsham can do both.
Sam Seal.
And that's what it is. Squibs it. Clock goes as soon as someone touches it. Seal.
It's hot down here. It's about close to 90 degrees on the scoreboard clock up there, and I imagine on the floor it's hotter than that, but both teams do have air conditioners behind their bench. That'll help somewhat, but you know those big heavy jerseys the Raiders offensive linemen are wearing could very well take a toll in the second half. But Lester Hayes told me yesterday that there are three or four passing combinations he's deathly afraid of, and he hoped that the genius up in Northern California wouldn't figure it out. One of those passing combinations was a deep fade pattern that Jerry Rice ran just before the half that set up the last field goal. So apparently, the genius of Northern California.
13-3 halftime lead. Only one touchdown in the game. Joe Montana to Roger Quaig for 20 yards. The rest points have come on field goals. Taking a look at the halftime statistics, Wayne, it has not been the day for the runners.
No, it has not. The 49ers have done an excellent job on Marcus Allen. He's had 10 carries and has only have about 34 yards in the game. On the other hand, they've held Roger Quaig, the Raiders have, to 7 yards.
And Wendell Tyler has 25 yards. Joe Montana has gone to Quaig 5 times, including the only touchdown in the ball game. And Jerry Rice, the rookie, has caught 2 passes for 71 yards. So Joe Montana now with 4 touchdown passes and 3 interceptions. His opposite number, Jim Plunkett, also had a pretty good first half, to say the least.
I think he did, and he threw the ball extremely well downfield early to Hester, and I think they're going to have to do more of that.
Hester caught 2 passes, and Doki Williams 3. Surprisingly enough, Todd Christiansen didn't get more of a call. I know that's one of the things the 49ers were wary of.
Well, they popped him short a couple of times, but the 49ers told us yesterday that they were going to double cover Todd Christiansen every chance they've had.
Chris Barr will be kicking off. The 49ers, of course, perhaps the top rushing team in the NFL, have only run 11 times in the ball game.
Well, that's what we talked about, you know, his list of 25 plays, that master list that Bill Walsh had. We told you at the top of the telecast that the bulk of them were the short passes. Now, they'll change things up at halftime, and I think they'll run the ball quite a lot more than they did.
But Chris Barr, who is accounted for the 3 points with a 25-yard field goal in the first half, will be kicking off to Carl Monroe and Derek Harmon. Monroe on the left, Harmon on the right. Underway in the second half. Monroe at the goal line. Turning outside and brings it out to the 26-yard line, where the 49ers will go on offense. Tackle made by Clee Montgomery. How are the teams doing on first down? 49ers have doubled the Raiders' output. They have the ball at the 26, first and 10. Joe Montana, their leader, faced heavy blitzing against Atlanta, not so much in this game against the Raiders. Wendell Tyler and Roger Quaig, the runners, Tyler in motion. Pass inside intended for Dwight Clark, and we may have a pass interference call against Lester Hayes, reaching in.
I'm sure Lester is saying, me, are you kidding? Because I think he thought he made a pretty good play on this.
And Pat Hackerman may be saying, yes, you.
Defensive pass interference, number 37, first down.
It was Hayes who told us yesterday that Bill Walsh hopes for distinct mismatches, just as Joe Gibbs did when they were on the same staff in San Diego.
Looks like a good play to me, too, Lester.
I'll second that. In any event, it's a first and 10 for the 49ers on their own 35-yard line. Bill Ring is now at fullback, and Ring goes in motion. Tyler stopped up the middle and then thrown for a loss. Back to the 31 by Rod Martin. Big play man has lived up to that billing today for the Raiders.
Sure is. He's got the speed and the quickness to make plays like that.
He can rush the passer. He can penetrate in the backfield. He's in the right spot in the right time. And you remember him at those three interceptions in Super Bowl 15 against the Eagles. Loss of three, second down and 13. Back at the 32-yard line. Roger Craig comes back in the lineup. Jerry Rice to the bottom of your screen. Dwight Clark to the top. Short drop for Montana. He's going to take off. You saw a defender and wisely slid in at the 35-yard line. Stacy Turan, and he might have shaken up that wrist a bit. Greg Townsend also in on the play. Remember, Montana had to come out of the opener with Minnesota.
And almost the same kind of play. That was an ankle. That looked like his wrist there.
It'll be third and nine for the 49ers off their own 36-yard line. And he gives it to Tyler, who loses the ball. And the Raiders recover. Frustration etched on the face of Bill Walsh, and Wendell Tyler had his troubles fumbling twice in the opener with Minnesota at crucial times, coughs it up here.
He got the handoff in good shape. Looked like he had it put away, but someone came in and pulled his arm back, and out went the ball.
And the first turnover of the game by the 49ers. And I'm interested the next time Montana comes out how his wrist is, because it was a passing situation and he handed off on that play.
Exactly.
Meanwhile, the Raiders, with a break here, have first and 10 at the San Francisco 38. It was Rod Martin, by the way, who recovered the fumble. Another big play for Martin. So a chance for the Raiders, who trail 13-3. That lead looks more precarious now, the 10-point lead. Jesse Hester in motion. Plunkett goes to Hester out on the flat. And a fine naked Marcus Allen. Hester was in motion, but it was Allen who was out there, and a defensive play by Todd Shell, who prevented Allen from getting a lot more. Gain of about four. It'll be second and six, long six, at the 35-yard line. This time, Hester and Doki Williams come out wide left. That's Hester. And that's Hawkins. Hawkins gets 2 yards on the play. Mike Walter making the stop. And it'll be third down. Mike Walter, another new face in the 49ers starting lineup defensively this year.
Of course, Jack Reynolds is not there. Mike Walter, number 99, playing in his spot next to Ricky Ellison on the inside in their what they call their base defense, the 3-4.
Mike Walter, formerly with Dallas, drafted as an outside linebacker, and the Niners moved him inside. Third down and five at the San Francisco 33 for Jim Plunkett. Dean trying to put pressure on. Pass is caught by Marcus Allen. Question is, did he get enough for the first down? Dwight Hicks supplied the lick on Marcus Allen, and we'll see where they spot the ball. He may be short by about a yard. Plunkett looking over to the sideline. It's early here in the third quarter, 11:20 to go.
Like they have a tight end about ready to go in a game, which would lead you to believe that they're going to try to crank it out.
It'll be fourth down. Just about two, and the Raiders trailing 13-3. Want to establish some momentum here and are going for it. Hawkins and Allen in the backfield. Plunkett. Throw. Incomplete. Incomplete intended for Hawkins. And now Hawkins shoves Ricky Ellison. And Ronnie Lott is telling Ellison, just get back. So a mild skirmish, but the net result is that the Raiders turn it over on downs, and the 49ers will take over first and 10 as they stop the Raiders fourth and 2.
Away from that, they certainly did with that last call. It didn't work, but, you know, it might the next time.
Tom Flores, who has been a Super Bowl winner, saw a big opportunity go by the boards there, with the score remaining 13-3, San Francisco. Bill Walsh, sigh of relief after Wendell Tyler had fumbled in his own territory. Meanwhile, Derek Harmon has come in for Tyler at running back. We'll see how Joe Montana comes out after that wrist injury, whatever it was. He's going to throw the ball on first down, in trouble. Back on his 30-yard line, Montana's pass is caught by Russ Francis at the 42-47. And that answers the question on Joe Montana's arm, his wrist. Van McElroy making the tackle, good for 17.
It was a safety blitz that time by the Raiders. 36 Mike Davis will come in from the right. He's picked up. Montana gets out of the pocket, though, and this is what the Raiders are worried about when he rolls to his right. 85% efficiency.
First and 10 for the 49ers. At their own 47-yard line, Russ Francis, the veteran, who spent most of his career with New England. Wendell Tyler checks back in the ballgame. Freddie Solomon in motion. And here's Tyler with John Ayers blocking. And Tyler gets the ball to midfield.
First time we've seen the 49ers basically try a sweep, pulling the guards and getting them out in front today. And that's part of the thing we said they do. They're going to run the ball in the second half and protect that lead.
Stacy Turan from the secondary and inside backer Matt Millen combined to make the tackle. Sellout crowd here at the Coliseum. This is the first time in the regular season they had sold out early enough to lift the blackout. This is the 26th game here in the Coliseum, the fifth time they've gone over 90,000. Second down and 7 at midfield. Tight end John Frank in motion, and here's Roger Craig. Penalty marker down, and Craig loses a yard, and Rod Martin, who has been the outstanding defensive player throughout the game for the Raiders, made the stop on Craig, and the 49ers will lose some more yardage. Penalty against them.
Rod Martin just stuffed a pretty tough blocker there, too, and John Frank took him on, shoved him in the backfield, and then made the play. Excellent defense. Howie Long said John Frank's like the little kid in your neighborhood you keep beating up on, and he keeps coming back after you.
He's tough, Frank.
Holding. Number 56. Offense. Still second down.
Center Fred Quillen. Number 56.
56 rolling top of your screen. Number 56 coming down on the back of his legs there, I think. And an arm around him.
Second down and 17. Time remaining in the third quarter and plenty of it. Montana swings it out to Craig. Not a good pass, and fortunately for Craig, Matt Millen was storming in there. A couple of scores to bring you. The Jets leading the Packers 7-3 in the third quarter. These Raiders trampled the Jets 31-0 in their opening game. And Miami leading one of the surprises of the early season, Kansas City 7-0 third quarter in the Orange Bowl.
Surprise low scoring game there with their passing attack.
Third down and 17 for Joe Montana and the 49ers. Jerry Rice has just checked in with a play from Bill Walsh. 49ers have converted only one of six third down situations. Montana stepping up. And Howie Long took the brunt of that. He doesn't mind it. Fourth down.
Long is number 75, takes an inside rush on Keith Fonhorst and gets that penetration that we talked about. Montana's out of the pocket now. Long is after him and caught that one in the numbers. Good safe place to throw it.
Max Runiger will kick. Lee Montgomery is back. And Montgomery has to go way back, and a terrific kick by Max Runiger goes out of bounds at the 7-yard line. Big break for the 49ers. Inside their own 20-yard line. They're in their 7-yard line as they start this drive with 8:34 to go. Trailing San Francisco 13-3. Marcus Allen gets by two defenders and brings it out to the 20-yard line and still going. That's the run of the game. Eric Wright knocked them out of bounds.
Great run because the 49ers had a defense pretty well. They were in good position for this cutback and the bouncing out over here. Look at the white jerseys. There's Williamson, 27. He just broke that tackle. That was the key one that got him outside.
Seemed like everyone in the secondary had a shot at him. First and 10 at the 25. That's an 18-yard pickup for Marcus Allen. And a lot of breathing room now for the Raiders. Allen going in motion. Plunkett up the middle to Christiansen. And Christiansen gets 9 yards before Ricky Ellison slows him down.
Good call by Jim Plunkett. He does call his own plays. One of the few in the league that does. Christiansen is 46. Now they're going to try to double him with the two inside linebackers, Ellison and Mike Walter. But Christiansen doesn't allow for it. He takes a little turn inside and then pivots back out to get away from those people.
John Makovic of the Chiefs said Christiansen gets off best without illegally pushing off, as well as any tight end in the league. Second down and one. Passing on second and one. Plunkett complete to the 39-yard line to Marcus Allen. Mike Walter is at the bottom there. And a first down for the Raiders.
Plunkett with good time initially, and then he got hit just as he released, and a good catch on a low ball.
So Marcus Allen, despite, along with his good running, has also caught 6 passes today. 7 minutes remaining in the third quarter. First and 10 Raiders on their own 39. There goes Allen again. Hawkins. And Hawkins to the 42-yard line with Manny Tuiasosopo makes the stop. By the way, Michael Carter, who was back after that hamstring problem, re-injured a hamstring, and he may not be back the rest of this game. Let's check in with a couple of baseball scores. And we will do it after this play as the Raiders come out 2nd and 7 on their 42, trailing the 49ers 13-3. It was 10-3 after one quarter. Plunkett going up on top. Doki Williams, and with him all the way was Ronnie Lott. Incomplete. Here are those scores. California leading Cleveland 9-8 in the 8th inning, and Minnesota ahead of Kansas City 7-3. That's a final score. The Twins beat the Royals. So California will take a 1-game lead if they hold their game. Toronto losing to Milwaukee, the Yankees beating Baltimore, and the Yankees coming back. They had dropped 7 in a row. And the Dodgers beat the Giants 5-3. And National League score. There they are. Third down and 7 on the 42. Christiansen goes in motion. Plunkett. Penalty marker down. Christiansen beating the defender, Todd Schell, and couldn't hold on to it. But there's a flag down right behind the line of scrimmage, holding against the Raiders.
Penalty is indicated.
Ray Guy is already in.
Holding, number 79, offense declined, fourth down.
That's Bruce Davis on the left side. Penalty declined.
Right-hand side of your screen now. 97 is Big Hands Johnson working against Davis, and that's the hold.
And it was Bruce Davis with the big hands there. Fourth down and seven, and Ray Guy will kick, and Dana McLemore goes back for the 49ers. Good high kick. Fair catch called for by McLemore at the 19-yard line, and so for a change, the 49ers will not have good field position following a 39-yard punt and no return. Since the Raiders have moved to Los Angeles, but intense rivals who have won all but one of the Super Bowls in the 1980s. The 49ers, who lead the Raiders 13-3, sellout crowd at the Coliseum, first and 10 on their own 19. Montana on a fake reverse, looking to throw, and he's got Freddie Solomon. Check that Wendell Tyler downfield on a fake reverse, incomplete. Defending on the play was Van McElroy and Brad Van Pelt,
and had him wide open too. Montana will tell you if there's any chink in his armor or any shortcoming, it's the long pass, the long passing game. He had Tyler two or three steps open that time and overthrew him.
Second down and 10. Bill Ring and Roger Craig both in the lineup, and here is Craig, and coming in is Bill Pickell at nose tackle, penetrating nicely with a big play and a loss for Roger Craig of six.
Pickell's a guy that the Raiders drafted number two 3 years ago, and people kind of laughed at him because he hadn't played much in college, missed 10 games his last 2 years when he was at Rutgers, but he can do it.
Raiders say he's their best tackler up front. They've been playing behind Reggie Kinlaw till now. Third down and 15 for Montana. His pass to Dwight Clark is caught, complete, shy of the 35-yard line, and good for a first down. So when in doubt, Joe Montana goes to his favorite target.
A great touch throw, too. Now, they're playing zone over here. Look at Lester Hayes playing it loose. He's got short help from Rod Martin, the linebacker. Or rather, that was Haynes. And Montana lofted it in there. And a good job up front here, Fonhorst.
Play action pass. Montana finds it open. Jerry Rice. And another first down into Raider territory. Van McElroy makes the tackle. A 23-yard pickup to the 43-yard line. And the rookie sensation is showing why the 49ers traded up to draft him.
Yes, he showed you his speed on that fade pattern that Irv Cross talked about. Now watch his jumping ability. He just goes up and plucks this one out of the air. And we talked to him a couple weeks ago, Dick. He said, I've always had great hands. He said, I got hands like sponges.
And they're big hands as well. And he said he was so embarrassed as a youngster that he kept his hands in his pockets. That's how self-conscious he was. Roger Craig on first down, straight ahead to the 37-yard line. Tackle made by Matt Millen and the strong safety Mike Davis.
This was the time of the game now that Bill Walsh felt that he could probably start running a little bit against the Raiders because their defense would be tiring down.
The big play getting into Raider territory. Two passes. Dwight Clark for 20 and Jerry Rice for 23 as the time. Down to 4 minutes remaining. Second down and four. At the Raider 37, Tyler in motion. Craig, first down, and more. And it was Van McElroy who may have saved a touchdown. And a terrific block by Randy Cross up front.
Cross is 51 right there as he helps turn out on Howie Long and Wendell Tyler downfield getting a block for Craig. The man that Bill Walsh says is the best all-around back in football right now.
NFC Offensive Player of the Week. Told us yesterday, my teammates are counting more on me each time. I can feel it. First and 10 at the 21. Tyler spins his way inside the 15.
And Van McElroy again makes the stop.
Paul Hackett, the running back and receivers coach, says that Wendell Tyler likes running inside. He likes it when it's tough. He says all he has to do is remind himself that he's carrying that ball at this stage of the game. He said, we'll do it on the sideline, and he's got to be careful with it too, but he's a tough runner in these situations.
Pressure for the Raiders and for Tom Flores, defense, one of the best in the league. But right now, the 49ers moving the ball nicely. Second down and three on the 14-yard line. Tyler again in motion, and the pass is batted at the line of scrimmage, deflected. And it's Bill Pickell, the nose tackle, who got a hand on it. And it'll be third down and four for the 49ers. Pickell going out of the game. Jeff Barnes and the pass defense group coming in for the Raiders. 2:34 remaining here in the third quarter. There's been no scoring so far, and it's still 13-3 San Francisco. Flag is down. Montana finds Clark, who's in for the touchdown. But we'll wait and see with the penalty marker down. A 14-yard play to Dwight Clark. This will be a critical call here.
Defense, offside, decline.
The touchdown will count. Joe Montana to Dwight Clark, 14 yards. The penalty decline, and the San Francisco 49ers now lead it 19-3.
I'll tell you, throwing, going to the right, back across the grain, watching Plant throw across his body to the left after he's moving right. He knows exactly what he can do in those situations because they practice the scramble drill weekly.
And Ray Wershing in the try for the 20th point for the 49ers. 2:27 to go in the third. Kavanaugh holds, and the kick is good. 20-3, the 49ers have taken the lead. They went 80 yards in nine plays. Own two touchdown passes to Roger Craig on the first drive and to Dwight Clark on this last drive. It went 80 yards and consumed 3.5 minutes, and the 49ers lead it 20-3. The Raiders lost to Kansas City a week ago Thursday by 16, trail by 17 right now. And there you see Clee Montgomery on the left and Sam Seal on the right. Ray Wershing kicking off for San Francisco. Picked up short and carried back to the 40-yard line. It was Frank Hawkins on the receiving end. And there's Dwight Clark, who came into this game as a force late. Caught two passes on the scoring drive. Well, coming up next week on CBS Sports, it all begins with the NFL today. And this is the fine menu of games, including a Texas rivalry between Dallas and Houston, Green Bay and St. Louis, Minnesota, Buffalo, and the rest. Washington and Chicago, a big matchup between two teams who were involved in the playoffs last year in the NFC. Check your local listings. First and 10 for Jim Plunkett and the Raiders on their own 39-yard line. Plunkett loses the ball, and the 49ers have come up with it, and they're still going with it.
Milt McCall.
And Milt McCall is going to go in. Touchdown, San Francisco. It was Jim Stuckey who made the hit, and McCall took care of the rest. 28 yards.
Says a lot about the 49er depth. Stuckey and McCall are normally guys that don't get a lot of playing time. They're not the big names, but McCall playing because Keena Turner's out, came in on a blitz that time. Stuckey made the hit. The ball popped loose. McCall was right there with it.
26-3 the score.
Watch it here. Stuckey will come from Plunkett's right, left of the screen. There's the hit. McCall was back there also. He scrambles up, is down on it, realizes nobody's around him. And a former Stanford player whose dad played in this league goes in for his first career six.
5-year free agent from Stanford. He's 6'6", good leverage. There's Wershing. Kick is good. And with 2:03 remaining, and there's a penalty flag down. 2:03 remaining. Here it is from Pat Haggerty.
Defense, offside, decline.
Again,
good
penalty on the defense, decline. And now the score
27-3 in favor of the 49ers.
There's the sack by Stuckey. McCall on the ball once again, and he got a pretty good block initially, and then really didn't need any more.
And here's how Bill Walsh reacted to it all.
He likes it.
There's McCall. He is big. He's a good pass rusher coming in the nickel linebacking position. As you say, comes from a football family, most of whom went to Stanford.
Father was a doctor, played for the Bears. Milt McCall himself is going to med school.
Ray Wershing will be kicking off. Sam Seal on the left, Cleve Montgomery on the right. We'll see if they turn out that way when they break, and they will. 27-3 to score. It was 13-3 at halftime. And the 49ers have outscored the Raiders 14-0 in the second half, and we have 2:03 remaining in the third. Wershing puts his foot to it. Lee Montgomery at the 7. And Montgomery brings it out to the 35-yard line on a fine return. Derek Harmon making the tackle, 28-yard return on the kickoff. College football next Saturday on CBS. Texas against Stanford. Good intersectional battle.
UCLA, Washington. And they'll have something to say about the Pac-10 conference.
Texas victorious yesterday. Stanford came up short. Live, 3:30 Eastern on CBS Sports. First and 10 for the Raiders on their 35, and the time remaining in the third quarter. Here's Marcus Allen on a pitch. Hit hard. Mike Walter. And a penalty flag is down.
Spiking the ball.
Well, that's not because he got in the end zone. Could be out of frustration, disgust, peak.
Watch it here after a good tough run.
I tell you,
I don't know.
That's kind of an unreasonable call.
I think so.
Yeah. You can't take emotion out of an emotional game. That's a tough call. Second down and 8 at the 37-yard line. Plunkett swings it out to Marcus Allen. And Allen is out of bounds. They have a first down, and he does. Todd Shell on the tackle. The Raiders last 7 possessions. Missed field goal, lost it down, interception, fumble. They've struggled. And the scoreboard shows it. 27-3, 49ers lead. 1:15 to go in the third. Jesse Hester in motion. Low pitch. Marcus Allen trapped, but he can throw. He's not going to get a chance. Stover and Mike Walter were both came in on Marcus Allen.
Looked like that was going to be designed to be a toss and a pass off it right from the start. Nobody downfield. He was starting to get his passing grip on the ball and lost it. Got up, looked down immediately, but too many white shirts there.
Jeff Stover, who did not play football in college, was a shot putter at Oregon. Loss of 11. Second down and 21 for the Raiders. A half a minute remaining in the third quarter. Kenny King is into the backfield. Plunkett looking, goes to King. Incomplete. Juggled it and lost it out of bounds.
And a great throw too by Plunkett.
Bill McCall and Eric Wright were covering King on the play. Now with third and 21, 49ers bringing in the nickel package. The Jets over Green Bay, 17-3 in the third quarter. The Packers had beaten the other New York team. Miami up 14-0 over Kansas City in the fourth quarter in the Orange Bowl. KC headed for their first setback if it stays that way. Third and long, Plunkett down. Gary Big Hands Johnson with the fourth San Francisco sack of the ball game. Two of them by Dwayne Bohr.
One of the best pass rushers from the defensive tackle position around has been for years, 97. He's going against Bruce Davis, number 79, and you see the result.
7-yard loss on that play. Dana McLemore goes back for the 49ers, and there's Ray Guy. The last 25 years, he has been the top punter in the National Football League. They're going to let the clock run out. There's the gun, and that is the end of the third quarter here at the Coliseum with the score. The San Francisco 49ers 27, the Los Angeles Raiders 3. We now pause for a word from your local station. 49ers will take over first and 10. Along with Wayne Walker, this is Dick Stockton here at a sold-out Los Angeles Coliseum, but it's been a quiet day for the Raiders, who trail 27-3.
You've really got to give a lot of credit to that San Francisco defense. We've talked much about the Raider defense, but the 49ers have come in here now with four sacks and that big turnover by Milt McCall, and they have led the way.
49ers have not given up a touchdown since the first period last week against Atlanta. First and 10 at the 26-yard line. Montana audible, three wide receivers to the right. Roger Craig up the middle. And Bill Walsh's plan has always been, when you have the lead, eat up the time by keeping the ball on the ground.
And you bet, and they'll also stay in the huddle, and Montana will watch the 30-second clock and let it run down before he snaps the ball.
The defense has set the tone in this game for the 49ers with four sacks. Big interception by Shell. Milt McCall rumbling 28 yards with a fumble for a score. Montana down for the second time in the ball game. It was Sean Jones and Greg Townsend who combined. Jones, in his second year from Northeastern in Boston, came into the game leading the Raiders with three sacks. The
Raiders had 10 sacks that first game against the New York Jets, who were really hurting an offensive tackle. Blitz this time. You see Rod Martin and Davis coming in from the right, but it was the left side that collapsed.
Sean Jones goes out of the ball game. Freddie Solomon and Dwight Clark have come in the ball game at wide receiver for the Niners and come out a little to the left. Third and 16. Tyler. And Tyler is hit by Jeff Barnes. And it'll be fourth down in the Raiders' hold. Minute and a half gone by here in the fourth quarter with the 49ers leading 27-3. They led 10-3 after one quarter, 13-3 at the half, and then exploded for two touchdowns in the third quarter. Lee Montgomery goes back, and Max Runniger will punt for San Francisco. He's been punting well today. Sends Montgomery back as the ball goes out of bounds inside the 25-yard line. Let's check some finals around the league right now to bring you up to date. The Colts with their first win send the Lions to their first loss. New England outlasts Buffalo.
Pittsburgh shutting out Houston.
After their loss to Cleveland, they come back with a win, and the Saints win their first of the year, beating Tampa Bay. Denver over Atlanta, 44-28. The Falcons are now 0-3. Wild game in Cincinnati. Dallas comes back after their loss to Detroit with a win over Cleveland. First and 10 at the 27. Plunkett hanging in the pocket. Flips it out to Todd Christiansen. And a penalty marker is down. Free ball if he laterals it forward, but a holding penalty called against the Raiders. Let's check up on other scores today to bring up to date. Washington upset by Philadelphia. First win of the year for the Eagles, who had not scored a touchdown coming into this game. The Giants over St. Louis. Cardinals 2-1. The Giants are now 2-1.
Holding, 74, offense, decline, second down.
Shelby Jordan holding. In the fourth quarter, the Jets lead the Packers 17-3. So they've come back from their thrashing at the hands of the Raiders in the opening game in Miami, leading Kansas City 21-0. Second down and 18 for the Raiders. Back on their own 19-yard line. Three wide receivers. Plunkett under pressure. Dumps it off. That's Marcus Allen. Try to avoid the hit by Todd Shell, ducked down at about the 26-yard line. Mike Walder ultimately made the play.
And the 49ers playing extremely loose now on defense. They know that Plunkett has to get downfield with the ball if he's going to get the Raiders back in this game at all. And they're not going to allow that. That's going to be what's available probably to Plunkett as those dump-off passes short.
For all of the 49ers' fancy offensive style, a lot of people thought that their Super Bowl championship last year was keyed by their defensive play. That's been the story of this one. Third down and 12. Plunkett gets rid of it in time. Penalty marker down. And the pass is complete to Jim Smith.
Penalty flag on the play.
And another holding penalty against the Raiders.
In that area of the game now where the Raiders just really don't have anything going for them at all. It happens sometimes. Penalties. Mistakes.
Seventh penalty called against the Raiders. Pat Haggerty.
Dealing a face mask, 5-yard penalty.
5-yard call. Long afternoon for that man, Tom Flores. One of the nicer people you'll meet, and I guess you and Tom go way back.
We sure do. Played in the Eastwood Shrine game together. I hate to tell you when. The world was flat then.
That long ago, huh?
Yeah.
Third down and 16. Plunkett. Moving out, looking for a receiver. Going up on top. Penalty flag is down. Doki Williams is there, and the 49ers come up with the ball. Dana McLemore with the interception, but there was a flag thrown. We have had a bunch of those yellow flags thrown in the second half. This man's been on the screen more than anyone.
Attack, defense.
That'll nullify the interception, of course.
We told you that they were going to do a job on Christiansen if they could. Watch it right here. That's a defensive lineman that's got hold of Todd right there. That was Dwayne Board. Had him in for blocking, and they're trying to get deep.
Defense, first down.
Well, if you're going to hold, you might as well go all the way with it, right? Automatic first down for the Raiders. They spot the ball at the 26. Fifth penalty against San Francisco. 12 penalties in the game. 11:25 remaining in the fourth quarter of this one. Raiders trying to fight back into this game. Plunkett hits tight end Andy Parker. No, check that. Jesse Hester, who is tackled by Carlton Williamson. 13-yard gain. Ball at the 39-yard line. Hester, the rookie from Florida State, has caught three passes today for 77 yards. Plunkett. Doki Williams. Good move by Doki Williams. He knows what to do with it after he catches it and has another first down. Good for 20 yards to the San Francisco 41.
Doki Williams extremely quick. And when he played here at UCLA, he was on a team with two other wide receivers. I think they were the best names in football.
San Francisco.
They had Doki Williams, JoJo Townsell, and Carney Cormack.
Oh, those are great names, and easy for you to say. The 49ers will use one of their three timeouts with 10:45 to go in the fourth. Two teams, 1-1, and the Raider bench shows a lot.
Well, we talked about searching for an identity. They did have an opening game win over the Jets, but Marcus Allen told us at practice the other day that the Jets are really hurting in, and you know that really didn't mean much because they were in such bad shape. Lost to Kansas City, and they really thought that, you know, today they'd find out what they are.
They're still searching. First and 10. Raiders on the 49er, 41. Plunkett pumps it off. Todd Christiansen, and held up there by Ronnie Lott. Well, one of the teams that won its first game of the year, the New Orleans Saints, they beat Tampa Bay 20-13, and the Saints will travel out west to meet the San Francisco 49ers. Jeff Stover comes in and sacks Jim Plunkett, sixth sack of the ball game for the 49er defense, and that's been the name of their game today.
Stover, number 72, on a stunt. With great speed, Dick told you he was a shot putter at Oregon, and when the 49ers tried him out, they timed him at 4.6 in a 40, which is what some running backs run, and Plunkett is hurt.
He is in pain, and he's coming out.
I hate to see that. He's suffered a lot in his career with injuries. Always came back.
You don't know who else, as you look at Mark Wilson, the second string quarterback warming up, has been on the roller coaster experiencing the highs and lows of a pro football career more than Jim Plunkett, who reached the depths when he went from the Patriots to the 49ers and then got a job with the Raiders and then led them to a Super Bowl, asked to be traded, came back and came through again. Here is the play that forced the injury. Stover
got Plunkett off his feet and was exuberant with the tackle. I don't think it was intentionally dirty or anything like that, but it was a tough one for Jim Plunkett.
The oldest quarterback in the NFL at 37 is still shaking.
He wins, and he always gets back up.
Threw for 257 yards today and hung in there against all kinds of pressure. Possible dislocation of the left shoulder is the word on Plunkett. So Dana McLemore is back, and Ray Guy is in the punt with a good high spiral. And McLemore will let it come down. Takes a bounce and is down by the Raiders right about the 5-yard line. And they may mark it at the 7. Tonight on CBS starts with 60 Minutes, followed by Murder, She Wrote, Crazy Like a Fox, and Trapper John, M.D. A fine lineup starting, of course, with an all-new 60 Minutes. Matt Cavanaugh is coming the ball game, and so Joe Montana is through for the afternoon. Cavanaugh played most of the preseason for the 49ers, replacing Joe Montana. First and 10 for San Francisco at the 9-yard line. Into the line. Roger Craig. Reggie McKenzie. Rookie inside linebacker making the tackle. Joe Montana's day. Two touchdown passes.
His job's not over, though. You saw him signaling the plays in. Was Cavanaugh in there? Cavanaugh, of course, a lot stronger arm going downfield than Montana. Not as mobile, but a real quality backup quarterback.
Started one game and was victorious against Philadelphia last year. Second down and 8. Keeping the ball on the ground. Penalty marker down as Wendell Tyler carries it out to the 13-yard line. And yet another flag. Holding against San Francisco. Joe Montana went into this game with 3 interceptions thrown. He did not throw an interception in this game.
Offense declined, third down.
Declined, John Ayers.
this is not the holding, but watch number 77, Bubba Paris, against Townsend here. Bubba said he wants to dominate people. He's trying to win two out of three falls there.
I think he got it. It'll be third and five. Back on the 14-yard line with 8:50 remaining in the fourth quarter. Kavanaugh under pressure and down inside the 10. Rod Martin and Greg Townsend, who got the first contact. Martin gets credit for the third sack for the Raiders today.
Yes, I think Bubba Paris got Greg Townsend a little excited with the play before last, because it was Townsend who came in and really should be credited with that sack.
So Max Runniker, who has punted well for the 49ers from his own end zone, gets it away. Clee Montgomery in San Francisco territory. Out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Let's take a look now at the schedules of these teams, starting with the 49ers. They've got the Saints at home and Atlanta on the road. Those are two divisional foes. Chicago coming up October 13th. A rematch of the NFC Championship game of last year, a road game against the Rams. And Denver on the road in November. And the rest of the schedule. When you've got to play the AFC West, you've got your hands full.
Coaches always say about those schedules, it doesn't matter who you play, it matters when you play them.
The Raiders go to work next week against the Patriots on the road. First and 10 on the 34. Wilson gone for Doki Williams. And pass interference against San Francisco. Dana McLemore was not looking up at the ball when he made contact with Doki Williams.
That's the key. If you're looking back now, a defensive back can have incidental contact with the wide receiver, but McLemore was practically face guarding that time.
And that'll be a first and goal at the one.
Defensive pass interference, number 43, first down on the one.
And a shove to boot. A dislocated shoulder, excuse me.
Just going to say, we just got the word that it is indeed a dislocated shoulder for Jim Plunkett, so he will be gone and for a while, and he'll be missed.
And that really is too bad for the 15-year veteran, because he came to camp healthy, and at worst, the Raiders would have been 1-2. First and goal at the one. Wilson, penalty marker down. Wilson will go in unmolested for the score, but there was another flag down. Pat Haggerty's going to start doing commercials. He's getting so famous here. Penalty will be against San Francisco. It's declined. Touchdown Raiders. Their first touchdown of the game.
Good ball handling by Wilson here. Wants to play action pass. Nothing there. And then rolls it in. And you know, on defense, you hate to lose a shutout. You get very few of them in this league, and you hate to lose it when you're on defense.
Well, the 49ers had not given up a touchdown since the first quarter against Atlanta last week. Another one, and Barr, with Wilson holding, makes good. And with 8 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, we have another penalty. Another flag down. And Wayne, we've had a lot of penalties on placements today.
Too many men on the field. Defense good.
They still couldn't stop them. And it's 27-10 San Francisco, and we'll be back. If you're on the leading side, so for the 49ers, they can handle the heat a lot better, leading 27-10 with 8:15 to go. And the 49ers have a lot of their good hands people up front, Wayne,
expecting an onside kick.
Chris Barr will kick off. Dana McLemore is back at the 10-yard line, and the kick goes through. There's Bill Ring up front, and the onside kick is there, and it's down. John Frank, the tight end, was right there. Let's talk more about what's coming up next week on CBS Sports in the NFL. The Texas rivalry, Dallas against Houston, Green Bay against St. Louis. Cardinals trying to come back from the Packers, who trailing the Jets right now.
Minnesota on the rebound with Bud Grant back against Buffalo and the Giants against Philadelphia.
Other games, Washington-Chicago, and that may be the best matchup on the board. The Bears and the Redskins. It was the Bears who beat the Redskins last year in the playoff game. Tampa Bay against Detroit. The Rams against Atlanta, and the Saints victorious today over Tampa Bay against these 49ers. It all begins with the NFL today, so check your local listings. First and 10 for Matt Kavanaugh and the 49ers. On their own 48, Roger Craig, with a head of steam, barrels it out to the Raider 43. We wind down to 8 minutes remaining in this game, and a gain of about 8 yards.
Roger Craig yesterday told us this is the kind of game that that all good athletes love to be in. You got to look forward to playing in these kinds of games, a matchup against the Raider.
Quite an accelerator, as you saw in that 62-yard touchdown last week on many of the highlights. And you got a glimpse of it on that last play. Second and two. Slicing inside is Tyler. Might have gotten just one of those 2 yards.
It's a dimension, Dick, these two running backs, Tyler and Craig, that the 49ers didn't have when they defended their Super Bowl title in 1982. But they've got a great running game now with these two, as good as anybody's in the league.
Reggie McKenzie and Rod Martin combined to make the stop. One thing has been evident, the presence of Jerry Rice, who had a great first game against Minnesota and then made some rookie mistakes and dropped a pass last week, has caught 3 for 94 and has played most of the game as that second wide receiver. Penalty marker down, and Kavanaugh keeping it, looking for the first down on third and less than a yard. And yet another penalty. Offside, called against the Raiders.
Offsides, number 99, defense, first down.
Sean Jones, so another first down for the 49ers. Raiders, in many respects, are a kind of a team in transition. They're bringing a lot of new people along, like Reggie McKenzie, the inside backer. Sean Jones is another one. Trying to stay up there while they do it. Kavanaugh, penalty marker down, and pull down. Howie Long, the big arm. But a holding penalty called against San Francisco. Tell you, the Raiders have not given up any of their zeal in trying to get to the quarterback, even though it isn't Montana in this fourth quarter.
How would Howie Long say when you play the 49ers, it's borderline hatred.
Holding, 56, offense, second down.
Brett Quillen, did he have a chance here against Howie Long?
Quillen is the center in front of Kavanaugh, along with that quick charge that we talked about. And Quillen had him around the throat.
Fourth sack of the ball game by the Raiders. First and 10
ball spotted at the 46
for the 49ers to make it second and 18 at the 46 of Los Angeles. Another penalty, and Wendell Tyler going off the right side carries to the 40-yard line. Gain of 6. Bill Pickell and Mike Davis make the stop, and another penalty. We're getting a penalty almost every play now.
Illegal formation, offense.
Against the 49ers. Again, the review of the scores today. And in our game, Wayne, when people were talking about the vaunted Raiders defense and the 49ers' innovative offense, it's been the San Francisco defense.
They certainly did lead the way, and not giving up a touchdown until the last Raider possession. And then they pressured Plunkett extremely well as the game progressed. He had plenty of time when the game started, but they kept the pressure on him, and that was the big difference.
Conservative first half for the Raiders. tried some things in the second half, but soon it was too late. The defense made things happen for San Francisco. Second down and 23. Back on their own 49-yard line, Wendell Tyler on a sweep, carries it to the 47-yard line. Let's update the baseball today as we get to the final weeks of the 49ers at the Raider 47-yard line. Matt Kavanaugh finds an open Russ Francis. Russ Francis hard to bring down. Loose ball, fumble recovered by the Raiders.
So many fumbles happen in that area where the runner, the receiver is struggling for extra yardage and he's upright and people can come in and put those headgears on the ball and pop it out of there. Look at how many guys are in there. Five or six of them clawing, scratching, and the ball pops loose.
Lester Hayes recovered the fumble, but I was looking at that crowd. They really have not had much to cheer about today. The Raiders never led in the ball game. When Montana hit Roger Craig with a 20-yard touchdown pass to make it 7-0. That was it for all intents and purposes. Swing pass to Frank Hawkins. Hawkins still going. May have a first down. Close to it as he gets to the Raider 45. Todd Shell and Jeff Fuller. Fuller particularly, who's a defensive back who plays like a linebacker and a very strong hitter. It was Fuller who covered Nat Moore and Jimmy Cephalo in the Super Bowl. Torrey Nixon is in the game for the 49ers.
Almost got an interception.
Pass intended for Doki Williams. Here's Torrey Nixon, who was acquired by trade from the Washington Redskins. He was their number one pick, got off on the wrong foot in Washington. A holdout, reporting late. Played at San Diego State and has really come on here.
The 49ers have worked him out, brought him along very slowly, and they think that he's a good cover man, and I think they're going to start playing him some in the nickel situation. So.
Second down. And 10. Mark Wilson. Out of bounds, incomplete. In case you're wondering about Jim Plunkett, he suffered a dislocated left shoulder and is out of the ball game. Was sacked 6 times. Mark Wilson has been dumped once. Wilson in his 5th year has been kind of a puzzle. Maybe he hasn't come on exactly the way the Raiders had anticipated.
Seems like he takes him so far. He's gotten to play a lot in different situations. He started 10 games last year when Jim Plunkett went down with injury and is going to get that same opportunity now.
He has thrown more interceptions than touchdown passes in his career. Third down and 10 on the 46. Wilson up ahead and an easy interception for Ronnie Lott. Want to talk about a center fielder? That was Ronnie Lott on that play. Coming back to the Coliseum where he played at USC, Ronnie Lott picks one off. With 4:02 remaining. And it's been that kind of a day for the silver and black.
Just an overthrow here by Mark Wilson. Over the top of everybody, and Lott back there playing the center field, like Dick said. Picks off the pass that was intended for Todd Christiansen.
So Matt Kavanaugh leading the 49ers, who have really played as good a defensive game as you could expect. 7 sacks, 2 interceptions, one by Ronnie Lott, the other by Todd Shell, and a big play, Milt McCall picking up a fumble and going 28-yard touchdown run to really open the ball game up. First and 10 at the 33. Jerry Rice is in motion. And the flip. Roger Craig. For a couple, Craig scored his 6th touchdown of the year in the first quarter on the receiving end. One of 2 Joe Montana's passes.
A true athlete loves a tough environment. He said a tough environment is playing the Raiders.
Ronnie Lott getting a breather after that interception. 49ers came into the game without an interception in their first 2 of the season. They picked off 2 today. Second down, 11. Tyler with Bill Ring blocking. But coming in from the linebacking position, Jeff Barnes.
Jeff Barnes on the tackle.
Some big matchups coming into this one, Wayne. Keith Von Horst and Howie Long, Bubba Parris and Lyle Alzado. Of course, the receivers against the great cornerbacks of the Raiders. But as you can tell by looking at the fans leaving here, which side had the edge? 3rd and 11. Kyler in motion. Kavanaugh's pass is dropped by Jerry Rice. Covered by Mike Haynes. And it's 4th down. I haven't mentioned his name much today.
Mike Haynes you're talking about, because they don't throw the football over that way a whole lot. He's so good.
With 2 minutes and 39 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter, here before what was a sellout crowd at the Coliseum, the San Francisco 49ers lead the Los Angeles Raiders 27-10. Max Runniker is punting for San Francisco. Clee Montgomery is back for the Raiders. Very nearly blocked. Montgomery calls for the fair catch at the 26-yard line. 60 minutes will follow this game, except on the West Coast, an all-new version of 60 minutes. The story for this game has been the 49ing. Mark Wilson in trouble, goes down, and that's the 9th sack of the ball game. Dwayne Board has 3 of them, and that's been the big part of the story for the 49ers, as Tom Flores' team has gotten a beating because of that outstanding San Francisco defense. Jim Plunkett had to leave the game with a dislocated left shoulder. Joe Montana retired early with the big lead, but 9 sacks for 72 yards has really kept the Raiders off balance today. Winding down to the 2-minute warning here at the Coliseum, 27-10 is our score, and we'll return. As we are completing our 2-minute warning, Dick Stockton and Wayne Walker here at the Coliseum in Los Angeles. Everyone talked about the great cornerbacks for the Raiders against the receivers, and they are great indeed. And the 49ers, innovative offense and the crunching defense of the Raiders. One of them, of course, Lester Hayes, but San Francisco played a superlative defensive game today. Mark Wilson on 3rd and 25, going downfield, and it's knocked away by Torrey Nixon, and a pass intended for Jim Smith, and it'll be 4th down. Well, it's time to thank some people for their efforts today. We want to thank our spotter, Marty Aronoff. Roger Riley, our statistician, up here in the booth. Jerry Rice, the much-heralded rookie for the 49ers, caught 3 passes for 94 yards.
And I think just those 3 catches just showed the limits of his ability. Went deep with great speed, made a great leaping catch for 1.
4th down and 25. Mark Wilson is hit as he overthrows, intending for Marcus Allen. Incomplete. And the 49er offense comes on. We want to thank the executive producer of NFL Football, Terry O'Neill. Senior producer, Charles H. Milton III. And a fine job by our crew in the truck, John Faratsis, our producer, and Robert Fishman, our director. Mitchell Goldstein, associate producer. Brooks Graham and Philip Wilson, our field technical managers. Pierce O'Neill and Greg Callender, our broadcast associates, and all the rest, fine technical crew, bringing these pictures.